On the record.
About Wiranto, you can say
also
anything. No, about Suharto, it's not yet announced.
Yes.
But about Wiranto, it's okay.
Oh, yeah, Wiranto.
Will you sack General Wiranto, Mr. President? Will you sack him?
Oh, yes, of course. I will ask him to use a polite word. Ask him to resign.
And are you confident that the military will back this? Will the military back this? Do you think you will have the military backing, Mr. President?
No. The military will listen to us.
Did you say the military will listen to you, Mr. President?
Yes.
Now it's already listening.
Thank you, Mr. President. I appreciate it.
See, for us, it's a bit of a dilemma. I would like your advice. You know, generally, policy of the United States is very strong, that we oppose armed opposition movements and we support the territorial integrity of country. And so we generally don't meet with leaders of armed opposition groups. The major exception to that is when the other country, where the armed opposition group operates, wants us to.
The crucial time will be today and tomorrow. If nothing happens, then General Wiranto cannot do anything.
Right.
But if he happens to do that, you see, all the area military commanders will be against him.
Right.
That's what their loyalty.
Yeah, I think that it's unfortunate. I heard your interview that the media is spending so much time talking about coup attempts, which is not the real threat.
Yeah.
Right, I think that you have succeeded in getting the loyalty of the key commanders and that's not an issue.
Yeah.
Holbrook made the comment because he was asked.
Yeah.
No, it's quite interesting. He's made mention of it to talk about the Commission of Inquiry, not to talk about a coup.
No. I made that comment because, I'm afraid that General Wiranto would organize something.
Right.
So then when I'm sure that he is not, he doesn't do that thing, it's okay.
Okay. I wish you luck here.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Stanley, for coming here.
Oh, my pleasure. Thank you.
General Wiranto said that he will not resign. How will you enforce that, your request to him?
Well, if he doesn't resign when I go back to the country, then I'll ask him to resign. After that, I will remove him from office.
With the Associated Press, I asked you this question yesterday evening, Mr. President, so what you plan to do about your stubborn general.
Who?
Your stubborn general, Mr. Wiranto.
Yesterday, there was the rumor that a group of Muslim militants would make the demonstrations against the government, and we believe that, there were some quote-unquote dirty hands behind that. I don't know whether that belongs to the generals or not, but anyway, we gave the orders to the National Police Chief as well as the Commander of the Armed Forces and the Attorney General to take care of the situation, and they took care in the, they think, the best way.
At one stage of his life, Gusto did a stint as a sports writer for a Jakarta newspaper. It came in handy at the Vatican.
And don't forget the best goalkeeper in the world, Dino Zoff.
Dino Zoff. Oh,
he was a captain later.
Now
he's a coach.
You know, he's a trainer of our national team.
Ah, trainer.
Yes, Zoff. Very goalkeeper.
Yes. Yeah.
But do you know, Mr. President, that now our team in Italy, our international one,
you have Julio,
to take it for
Julio Cesar from Brasilia,
Ronaldo from
Ronaldo.
And now you have, very excellent Brazilian goalkeeper, Tipa. I think in your team here, in one of your teams.
You are quoted by a Portuguese newspaper as saying that if General Wiranto were convicted of the human rights abuses of which he is accused, he would be pardoned. Is this accurate? And if so, do you not think that people in high government positions should be held accountable for this sort of violation?
Oh, yes. After deciding that, I will pardon him. Because, I have my respect to him for the past several years. We have been in good terms. And I know that basically, whatever he has done in the past, maybe he's a plebiscite and so forth, but actually he was encouraging democratization process within the government process. I know this.
Letters reveal how Indonesian generals plan repression.
Dato, yang Malaysia. Mana ada Malaysia? Tadi ada di situ.
Iya, kalau enggak biar ya. Itu dulu.
Presiden mau tanya apa tadi, masih kurang jelas. Bapak Anda menyebutkan akan memberikan pardon kepada Jenderal Wiranto.
Udah dari kemarin-kemarin kok masih enggak jelas juga, itu maunya apa?
Pardon setelah dia dinyatakan guilty. Iya, bukan
yang
sebelum.
Lain-lainnya akan
tidak.
Enggak,
iya.
Ya, jelas.
Jadi pardon hanya untuk Wiranto setelah dinyatakan dia guilty.
Dia kepala staf, dia panglima tadinya.
Ya. Baik. Siap. Oke. Terima kasih.
Ini dari Malaysia belum datang.
Oh, ya sudah kan Unharis sudah setelah itu selesai sudah Unharis.
Ini independen sama, ya kira-kira begitu. Terus dia bilang sini, the documents implicate officer at every level of the military hierarchy. It is the missing link, one Western diplomat said. It connects the military to the use of repression and coercion, and it shows a clear chain of command from close to the very top. They will add to pressure for war crimes prosecutions against those implicated in the violence. Indonesia's most powerful General Wiranto continued to divide calls yesterday for his resignation by country's president, Drahman Wahid, increasing fears of split between the army and civilian establishment.
Mr. President, Greta Poymers.
From Ethiopia. Nice
thank
to
you,
meet
thank
you.
You.
Thank you for good spending time for us. Do you still trust General Wiranto? You asked him to resign.
Yes, I asked him to resign, but I trust him because, I asked him to resign just to avoid the international tribunal. It's not nice to have an Indonesian ex-commander of the armed forces to become to those international tribunals. So
you want to try him yourself?
Yes, and then because the law said that, but I myself, I trust him. I respect him.
But he refuses to resign. Now, does that mean that you're a weak president if you can't fire your ministers properly?
Well, I will go to him and I will explain to him that it's my prerogative to appoint ministers. So that this is very important. There are a kind of misunderstanding on this part. But anyway, for me, I respect him.
The more joke I tell, that means I have psychological pressure. But in order to make a good psychological escape, you have to have a real joke, not to calculate it. So you have to show the natural joke, natural way of telling jokes. That means that you have to enjoy the jokes.
Tapi kalau Pak Harto teriak-teriak sekitar umur udah tahu belum?
Belum.
Nah, jadi Pak Harto itu ngintip Pak Harto lagi lari keliling sumur yang nggak ada temboknya itu. Empat, Empat. Kan tertarik itu Pak, ngapain tuh orang empat. Waktu itu berdiri sebelah sana, Pak Artonya kan berhenti, bernapas. Pak Tri buru-buru ke pinggir apa? Ke pinggir sumur, dia ngelengok ke dalam ada apa. Tahu-tahu Pak Arto udah sampai di belakangnya didorong. Jebur. Lima.
Empat udah mati.
Jadi yang kelima itu dia.
How do you feel about the Attorney General's efforts on the Suharto case? Do you feel that he's done his best, or do you think it's going too slowly?
He has now sent a medical team to examine him, and then if it's found certainly that he's not fit for court examinations, then he will be placed under house arrest.
That would be quite a far-reaching step, wouldn't it? I mean, to place a former president under house arrest.
Yes, but we have to do that.
Are you afraid that he might flee the country, or that he might?
No, it's just a gesture to show the public at last that nobody is above the law.
Wiranto, ungkap presiden lagi, telah meneleponnya dan mengatakan, Gus Dur kok percaya pada omongan orang bahwa saya akan bikin kudeta. Saya tidak pernah mikir seperti itu. Karena itu saya percaya pada Pak Wiranto, tegas Gus Dur. Memang, kata presiden, ada anggota TNI yang tidak senang dan ingin memberontak, tetapi mereka tidak berani. Saya pikir seperti manusia, tentara itu ada yang baik dan ada yang buruk. Ada yang murni dan ada yang maling, kata Gus Dur.
Which bit?
Under house arrest or not?
Mm-hmm.
Don't put it in which paper.
I shouldn't put that in the paper?
Yeah.
The interview earlier was on the record, right?
Oh yeah, it's okay. But I never said about Suharto. I mean, about the Attorney General's conclusion.
That he should be under house arrest?
Yeah.
Oh dear, I sent the story. I need to cancel that.
Yeah.
Just as we were leaving, your dad said, sort of joking, oh, don't run that bit about Suharto in the paper. And before I could clear it up, he had to go off to the bathroom.
Uh-huh.
So I've called Hong Kong and asked him to hold the story, but I'm not quite sure where I stand on it.
Well, if you say that, then it means that he probably doesn't want to run that.
Right. But there are other things he told me, for example, that the three ministers were under suspicion of corruption, or Mazuki will announce investigation. I also included that in the story.
Where is he now?
He's just in the bathroom.
Oh, awesome.
I know he wants to rest. I don't want to, kind of cancel him.
Just cancel it, Jeremy, for the time being.
Okay, I'll cancel it. If you don't mind, when he wakes up, explain to him what I've done, and sort of explaining that from professional terms. Oh, I could be fired for that because
why don't let's compromise, let's make compromise. That's just, why don't you just lead with the ministers instead of Suharto? It's probably
just drop the Suharto. And I assume that he was doing one of his usual sort of throwing something out there and just waiting to see what the reaction was. Suharto, it's more specific.
Yeah.
It's a prediction of absolute truth.
I think just lead with the ministers if I were you. So you still have your news, and but he asked you not to use the Suharto bit, so it's a compromise for the us. You don't get fired, and we don't get people. We don't get butchered by facing the side.
United Nations continues to put pressure on Indonesia for not taking any real steps to charge or punish anyone over the carnage committed in East Timor. The threat of an international inquiry remains.
Itu salah satu argumentasi bahwa international tribunal ini baru kita bisa betul-betul stop
kalau orang lihat bahwa kita itu serius. Nah, kalau kita tidak tanggap ya, nanti dianggap bahwa kita tidak serius. Kita seakan-akan mau melindungi. At the same time, toh dengan turunnya Pak Wiranto, it does not mean the end of the world. Bahwa masih dihormati dalam pengertian bahwa untuk kepentingan bangsa ini keseluruhan, dia harus berkorban. Karena Robinson masih tidak puas dengan Kofi Annan sekarang ini. Dan masih mengejar-ngejar bahwa belum tentu Indonesia itu serius dalam menangani hal ini. This is I think one argument yang bisa di.
Kalau saya sih lain lagi.
Apa?
Bagi saya Wiranto harus turun itu karena kalau Wiranto tidak mau turun, tidak ada investasi di Indonesia. Itu aja.
Ya, bisa juga bahwa leader dari dunia ini mau melihat kesungguhan pemerintah kan?
Ya makanya keadaan aman tuh kalau Wiranto nggak jadi tidak berhenti gitulah dari tentara dan dari apa namanya menteri. Karena itu mereka jadi bagi saya itu masalah pokok. Kalau soal Kofi Annan soal itu ya pokok sih enggak ya walaupun penting ya.
Ya itu bisa jadi komplement saja bahwa di samping itu juga masalahnya kita menghadapi international community dari segi lain yang memang betul-betul mau promote human rights. Jadi dan dengan dia berhenti dari kabinet kan tidak berarti sudah dia dinyatakan bersalah. Paling tidak itu nanti court yang akan menyatakan dia bersalah atau tidak kan. Umpama pun dia bersalah, toh kita masih mau pardon dia. Jadi he is on the winning side sebenarnya.
Returning to Jakarta, and nothing's been resolved. Gusto has asked for Wiranto's resignation. Wiranto has declined to give it. To everyone's surprise, Wiranto has turned up to meet us, as if nothing has happened. The standoff continues.
Wiranto said that he was not against me in my position to ask him to resign. But he said that it will affect his career. Not his career, it will affect his family, the wife and the children, if he is fired. So then because of this, he should resign, but he has trouble resign now. Because there is no reason for that. So according to him, then we have to, you know, to wait a little for the announcement of the Attorney General on whether he is free or not from or guilty from the accusation of being involved in the violations of human rights in East Timor.
Still remain, yeah?
Yeah, in Bangkok.
He will ask,
you know,
Wiranto to resign.
In his last press conference, just before he departed from Bangkok, he still said that he would ask Wiranto to resign as he arrives in Jakarta.
So how could he remain in his principal?
Or maybe this is the way how he puts it now or something. Okay, my principal is still there, so I'm still asking him to resign. But this is just a chance to the Kejaksaan Agung. So, in the end, gitu aja kok repot-repot.
What a democratic... what a democratic way.
Indonesia. Yokoyama-san, you can say, I'm getting confused in Jakarta.
principle is still there. The principle that the president wants Severanta to resign. Not changed.
But he will not fire him in 1 month. But if he wants to step down himself, it's okay also. Something like that.
You must never underestimate Gusdur. On the other hand, at least for now, people will look at it that way, you know. On the surface, the president has changed, perhaps because of some pressure.
Perhaps, yeah.
I do not know what fate is. I only know I must be brave, and I must face the man who hates me. Now that I meet you,
itu film Hainun ya. Ditanya kok ya. Turun di stasiun kota kecil, mau nuntut balas kepada syarifnya gitu. Duel. Di syarif nungguin gitu lah. Padahal dia jam 10 mesti kawin. Kan udah terlanjur ditetapkan acaranya, datang berita itu. Dia pilih nungguin lawannya dah. Itu dia bilang, not forsake you, my darling. Kita harus berani.
After a series of meetings and phone calls that went on through much of the night, Gusdur came to the conclusion that Wiranto was actually working against him. This gave him no alternative.
I have decided to make Wiranto non-active from today.
Karena itu setelah kami bertemu dengan Presiden, dan saya jelaskan segala sesuatunya dengan jelas, baik untuk tugas-tugas yang saya lakukan sebagai Menko Polhukam maupun sebagai Menteri Luar Negeri Argentina selama beliau tidak ada di tempat, dan juga saya laporkan posisi saya di dalam permasalahan penegakan hukum terhadap pelanggaran hak asasi manusia di Timor Timur.
Udah tidak ada sih itu.
Maka beliau telah mengambil keputusan seperti yang tadi kita saksikan. Itu jelas hak beliau, hak presiden untuk buat keputusan terhadap para menteri-menteri termasuk Menko Polhukam. Maka posisi saya tidak dikatakan terlibat di dalam pelanggaran itu, tetapi bertanggung jawab atas apa yang terjadi yang disebut sebagai pelanggaran HAM di Timor Timur selaku penanggung jawab keamanan nasional.
There is enough evidence to put Wiranto to prison, and according to Wiranto, they lack the evidence. So in my position, I said that, well, anyway, it's redundant, because I said pardon for three types of people, presidents and former presidents, vice presidents and former vice presidents, and then commanders of the armed forces. Okay. So the three will be pardoned, whether they are guilty or not.
The sacking of General Wiranto is only the first step in the removal of the military from their control of Indonesia. Usually Gusdur avoids such direct confrontations. His political support base is so fragile that whenever possible he turns enemies into allies. Sometime in the future, General Wiranto may well reappear as an ally, just like Xanana Gusmao.
Kepada Bapak Presiden Abdurrahman Wahid, Bapak-Bapak Menteri dan seluruh anggota rombongannya yang kami hormati, kami mengucapkan selamat datang di bumi Lorosai. Hiduplah Gusdur! Hiduplah rakyat Indonesia! Hidup!
The biggest challenge Gusto faces will be to keep Indonesia together without resorting to the kind of repression practiced by Suharto.
Saudara-saudara sekalian, saya ingin menyatakan permintaan maaf atas apa yang buruk telah terjadi di masa lampau, baik kepada keluarga dan teman-teman korban Santa Cruz serta teman-teman dan keluarga dari mereka yang dikuburkan di Taman Pahlawan ini. Dua-duanya adalah korban dari keadaan yang tidak kita kehendaki. Mudah-mudahan di masa yang akan datang tidak akan terulang lagi. Terima kasih. Thank you.
Thank you.
Halo? Di mana?
Nobody wants